Let us now discuss about inductors in parallel combination without using mutual induction. Or when we talk about parallel combination of inductors, here we'll ignore the effect of mutual induction between the two inductor coils, as that is beyond the scope of these lectures. We'll discuss separately in advanced lectures. Say we have two inductors L1 and L2 connected across terminals A and B, and from terminals A and B, a current I is flowing. Obviously, through the two inductors, current will be divided as I1 and I2, and we can write the value of I as I1 plus I2. And if we talk about the potential difference across terminals A and B, or EMF induced, here we can write potential difference across A and B, VA minus VB. If current is increasing, the EMF induced will be like this, which will oppose the increment in current. This VA minus VB we can write as L1 dI 1 by dt, as well as this equals to L2 dI 2 by dt. Because the two inductors are connected in parallel, their potential difference must be equal to that across A and B. And the same VA minus VB we can write as L equivalent multiplied by dI by dt if the whole system is replaced by a single inductor between terminals A and B. Now, in this situation, if it is L equivalent, directly it is given as L equivalent dI by dt. Now, from this relation, we can write dI by dt is equals to dI 1 by dt plus dI 2 by dt. Now, in this situation, dI 1 by dt we can write as VA minus VB over L1, and dI 2 by dt we can write VA minus VB by L2, and similarly dI by dt we can substitute from here. See what result we are getting. It is VA minus VB upon L equivalent is equals to VA minus VB upon L1 plus VA minus VB upon L2. Here this term in numerator gets cancelled out. We are getting is 1 by L equivalent is 1 by L1 plus 1 by L2. And the expression is similar to that of the parallel combination of resistances. So you can always write that for two inductors in parallel, equivalent self-inductance can be given as L1 L2 or L1 plus L2. And for more inductors in parallel combination, we can use the sum of reciprocals is equal to the reciprocal of equivalent self-inductance. But be careful, this is the relation when we are neglecting M in this situation. Mutual inductance we have neglected, then only we are getting this. Another important thing we can see here is as L1 dI 1 by dt is equals to L2 dI 2 by dt, always we can write that L1 I1 is equals to L2 I2. The flux in the two will always remain same, because if we integrate the two expression, we are getting it. And as I1 is always I1 plus I2, then using these two relations, we can define the value of I1 and I2. As I1 here, we can write as L2 I over L1 plus L2. And I2 we can write as L1 I over L1 plus L2. This also verifies that the currents are distributed in two inductors in parallel in inverse ratio of their inductances. So when are required, you can also use these results for calculations of I1 and I2. Despite of the two inductors having ideally zero resistance, the currents in the two will not be same even in a steady state. These are the results of current not only in incremental state, but also these are giving the value of distribution of current in a steady state.